Prime Minister Anthony says he can understand the anxiety of businessman Michael Chastanet and his son, Alan, to get their hands on the levers of government. But according to the Prime Minister, Alan Chastanet should be the last person on earth to issue any invitation to him to quit.
Let's face the facts. Alan Chastanet could not win a seat in Sufra. He was soundly defeated in Sufra by Harold Dalson. But what is worse is that it looks like he wants to take St. Lucia through another trauma, like the one he took the country through when he was Minister of Tourism. Everybody remembers the fiasco of boxing in paradise. We all remember the HEPO issue. Then all the evidence indicates that the catastrophes we had in respect to the Daher Mall, as well as the loss of hundreds of acres of land in Black Bay, in the south of the island, were in fact caused by decisions involving Alan Chastanet.
Dr. Anthony notes that Alan Chastanet was at the center of the losses the government and people of St. Lucia incurred, because he was part of the decision-making process under the last United Workers' Party administration and encouraged the investments.
To this day, the governments of the Eastern Caribbean remember his behavior over the Suriname Airways matter. The embarrassment that he caused not only to sit in Prime Minister King, but also to the governments of Antigua and St. Vincent. I think this country has to be protected from Alan Chastanet and his father. And very clearly, it will be for the people of this country to decide at the right time whether they feel they can trust these two to manage the affairs of the country. It's not just about the UWP. It is really about Alan Chastanet and his father. Both of them seem to be promoting the same agenda at the same time.
On the question of early elections, the Prime Minister's response was not at all. Some observers have said that the series of town hall meetings being held by the government and represented an attempt to judge public opinion with a view to possibly calling an early poll. For the DBS News World, Melissa Paul reporting.